take it away. Thank you. Hello, everyone. Well, my name is Anisa Kuci, and I come from Albania. Besides being a GNOME contributor and user, I'm also part of other communities, free software communities, back in my country. And I've been part of a hacker space there, and that's where I got to know what free software is, and that's where I started contributing and also helping on building communities. Back in Albania, I've been part of different projects, and one of them is OpenStreetMap, and that's why I've taken it as a showcase for this 5-minute lightning talk. And I'd like to only give some hints on what I think communities can do to grow bigger. Afterwards I'll show some pictures from our OpenStreetMap community back in Albania, which was very very diverse and very active, and it was taken often as an example by other communities in other countries on how to maintain a group of people to continue working voluntarily. My first advice or hint was to have physical spaces for people to work, because we realized that when we do, for example, small mapathons or editathons to edit the map, especially for new contributors, they were very successful and people were very much enjoying them. And it brought many new people in the community, which would also happen with other projects as well, not only OpenStreetMap, but I was mostly included in that project. And it was also creating a very positive vibe for the community, and people were trying to socialize as much as possible and be very welcoming to the newbies. Another idea or hint on how to grow community was regional cross-border collaborations. And we try to do that as much as possible, because we were having collaborations with OpenStreetMap in Kosovo, or OpenStreetMap Greece or Italy, or even Belgium, and it was very nice to exchange experiences and knowledge between communities. We were trying to be as careful as possible on having a diverse community and having balance between not only men and women, or not only gender balance, but also to have balance on the backgrounds of people that we're kind of aiming for, because we wanted people not only to have, different genders, but also different backgrounds, different ages, who wanted as much inclusion as possible. So we didn't have only a target group that was, students, but all people that would be hopefully interested in the project. So I believe it was something that we're doing good enough, and we're succeeding. Very often we would organize these little mapathons, and they were very, very friendly, and they would create this very, very not, not very confidential kind of environment, and people were not shy to join. Like no matter what they knew about the project, and it was very nice to have them around and not having them being complexed. And another good point is to take good pictures of the events and also have good documentation, because many people who stay back at their homes have no idea what's happening in the event, and if you try to show them by having good pictures and good documentation, it makes the whole process easier and makes people feel like they can join and they don't have the complex of what's going to happen there. So yeah, these were some very short hints and or ideas that I had. And thank you very much for listening.